greetings, this is David. I'd like to begin with a short scripture reading, one of my favorite readings from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Put on, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. And over all of these, put on love, which is the bond of perfection. Let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were called in one body. So St. Paul basically is telling us how to get dressed, spiritually speaking. We get up each morning and we think about what clothing I'll wear, what wardrobe. And we also need to consider what we will put on, spiritually speaking. St. Paul tells us to put on compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, and over everything else, so that this could be seen for everybody, put on love. A couple days ago, my wife and I went to a little Mediterranean restaurant near our home to buy just a few pieces of flatbread. We had all the food we needed, but we had run out of bread. So we walked in and asked, how much is the bread? And the lady at the counter said, oh, it's $1 each. And we said, okay, we'll take 4 pieces of bread. And then she said, okay, and what else would you like? And I told her, that's all. We have our food at home. We just need the bread that we ran out of. And she put the bread in the bag and said, here, you can just take it. And it's like, wow, thank you. These are little blessings that God sends us along the way. And we can all be used by God to give blessings to one another. And I was very touched by the kindness of the lady at the Mediterranean restaurant. Yesterday, I went to the grocery store to buy some bananas and an avocado. And as I walked in, they were having people finish and checking out, but they said the store is closed. And I just kind of put my head in the door and said, is it okay if I just come and buy some bananas and an avocado? And she said, sorry, we're closed. And I'm like, okay, thank you. And I walked out. And as I was opening up my car, a gentleman walked up and he opened his bag of groceries and he said, I heard you needed bananas and an avocado. He said, I just bought a bunch of bananas and some avocados. Let me give you an avocado and a couple of bananas. And it's like, again, it's like, wow, what kindness, you know, 2 days in a row. These kind of things really make a difference. Little acts like this. Mother Teresa said, there are no great acts, only small acts done with great love. And that's the way that we can change the world. One person at a time, with Jesus in our heart, we do acts with great love. And we have people talking about we need a revolution right now. It's time to change the world. And they have ideas that are based on what they feel is good and right and just. And many of their ideas are good and right and just. But you cannot change the world and make it a better place by throwing bricks through windows and throwing bricks at police officers, throwing Molotov cocktails. A revolution started in violence will not be anything that'll have good fruit, okay? There's only one revolution in this world that really matters. And one of the people who was following the leader one time took out a sword and cut off someone else's ear. And the only act of violence done in this entire revolution, and the leader told the person, put your sword away, those who live by the sword die by the sword. And then he healed the ear of the person who had his ear cut off. And so that revolution is the only one that matters. The leader was captured, brutally treated more than any person ever, eventually given a cruel death. And then on the third day, he rose from the dead. And life triumphed, and death was conquered, and love ruled. And that's the only kind of revolution that we need. A revolution of love, a revolution of kindness will really change the world. I have a worker I've blessed to have met, you know, a couple of years ago, and he's done some work on my house quite a bit. person is very, very important to me, because not only is he a good worker, but he's a very good, honest human being, and I consider him a friend. Last week, he spent a couple days working on my garage, and when he was leaving the second day, and I asked him how much money would I need to pay you, and he showed me how much the materials cost, and then he told me how much the labor costs, and he said, I'll take that labor fee and cut it in half, and you take the other half and donate it to the GoFundMe account that you set up. Now, my GoFundMe account is to help a little girl named Jocelyn. She's 11 years old with a terminal brain tumor, and the family needs a lot of financial help getting all kinds of medicines, natural medicines that are not paid for by any type of insurance, and it's expensive. And so he just touched my heart with this act of kindness. Okay, so, you know, people that are willing to donate money to help a little child, people who are willing to come out and give me a couple bananas or an avocado, someone who says, okay, you can just have the bread for free in the restaurant. These are the things that change the world, because they change the world from within people's hearts. Change people's hearts. Change people's hearts, and you have a real revolution that will be a lasting revolution. Thank you for listening to me viewing this little video. Please stay tuned, as there will be messages to come each day for the next few days. God bless everyone. Let peace reign in your hearts. You want a revolution? Well, you know, we all want to change the world. You tell me that it's evolution. Well, you know, we all want to change the world. But when you talk about